Captain's log, stardate 47111.1. A Federation listening post along the Romulan neutral zone has detected an unidentified vessel headed for Federation space. The Enterprise is moving to intercept.
At its reported heading and velocity, the vessel will enter Federation space in approximately 47.3 seconds.
Go to yellow alert.
We have the vessel on sensors.
The ship is a Garidian scout ship. They are driving their engines too hard. Their warp core is critical.
The Garidian? What is the status of their relationship with the Romulan Empire?
They are on friendly terms and may share technology.
We are being hailed.
On screen.
Help us. We are fleeing political persecution. We seek asylum. We are being persecuted.
Their signal is breaking up.
What do you make of this, Number One?
It could be a trick.
The Garidians have earned a reputation as honorable warriors, Captain. They do not ordinarily resort to trickery.
We are within visual range. The Garidians' warp drive is failing. They are dropping to sublight speed inside Federation space.
Slow to impulse.
Warbird decloaking directly ahead. The Warbird is also Garidian. They are hailing us.
This is an internal Garidian matter. Withdraw at once.
You are violating Federation space.
They have cut off transmission.
The Warbird has locked its tractor beam onto the scout ship.
Go to red alert.
These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no one has gone before.
Captain's log supplemental. A Garidian warbird has violated the neutral zone in pursuit of a scout ship. The fugitives may be seeking political asylum, but as yet we have been unable to confirm their intentions.
Hey everybody, welcome to another video, another Star Trek video. So this is Star Trek Next Generation Final Unity. Yeah, another game in the series. One from my channel that you can't actually get anymore. You can get quite a few Star Trek point and click adventures on GOG and Steam, but not this one, or at least I haven't seen it anywhere. So yeah, again, I've got the original discs for this still. It was a bit of an arse for this to get to run. Actually, it wasn't too bad really. I just had to muck around. I had to like look up a tutorial on YouTube and a little bit of sort of copying files from what are you doing, Picard? Right, okay, thanks. Eyes forward, Picard. A little bit of cutting and pasting of the disk and the files off the disk onto the C drive and using, this uses DOSBox, you know, so this is, you maybe noticed at the start there, it was 1995 this game came out, so it's actually predates, so, you know, it's, it predates Windows 95, basically, so DOS, Windows 3.1, well, wouldn't have run Windows 3.1. So yeah, so I got this disc in the same bundle that I got Birth of the Federation. It was Birth of the Federation, Final Unity, Klingon Honor Guard, which I've actually got sitting next to me. I might maybe play that as well at some point. And also the game tie-in with Star Trek Generations. What's Riker looking at now? I forgot what you're doing. But, okay. Yeah, I should maybe actually like do something. So yeah, just a basic like point and click. Some of my friends played this a bit. I've never really played this game that much. I don't know what the... What, Deanna's looking at something now. What are you looking at? Anyway, let's see what Data's saying.
Mr. Data, do you have any suggestions?
Right. As long as the Warbird maintains a tractor beam on the scout ship, we cannot beam its crew aboard. However, if we maneuvered the Enterprise between the ships, we could temporarily disrupt the tractor beam.
We will have to drop our shields to use the transporter.
Right, so I've maybe played like maybe the first 10 minutes of this, and I know that is something that's what you have to do. There's all sorts of different ways of going through this game, and depending on the difficulty level, I think that changes the story as well. But we'll, I know that this works, so we'll do this.
We'll have to.
We have broken the Garidian's tractor beam. The crew of the scout ship has been beamed aboard.
Good work.
Captain, the Warbird is hailing us.
On screen.
On screen.
Federation starship. This is nice. An internal Garidian matter. You've been warned not to interfere.
I like your lipstick. Right, what would Picard do? Picard or Kirk? Let's see. Or maybe even Janeway. This one.
Your presence here gives me every right to interfere. Why have you violated the neutral zone?
They are locking their disruptors on us.
Shit!
Captain, you are harboring dangerous criminals. I demand that you transfer them to my custody immediately.
Not a chance. Is that... Oh, okay.
Our Garidian guests were rescued in Federation space. Any extradition will have to proceed along normal diplomatic channels.
You know that there is no formal extradition treaty between our governments.
Oh well. Snooze you lose, I suppose.
Captain, one of the criminals is my son, Avakar. Return them and I swear they will all receive a fair trial.
I sympathize with your concern for your son, but that does not justify your violation of the neutral zone. You will leave Federation space at once.
Very well. You have won this time, Captain. But I promise you, there will be a next time.
The Warbird is heading back toward Garidian space. They are activating their cloaking device. Captain, our new arrivals are requesting to speak with you. Their names are Lucana, Avakar, and Tabak.
What are your orders, Captain?
I should like to consider the situation a bit further.
And get some Earl Grey tea as well. Right, so this is, you know, really quite well done, this, actually, I think, given that it's all the actual voice actors. You know, for a game, 1995, you know, this doesn't look too bad. And that, like, the rendered cutscenes at the start, you know, they were quite impressive. But this, barely remember anything about this game. Prophecy, or I don't know. I think we can speak to... Yeah, there we go.
Captain Picard, can you help us contact a Vulcan archaeologist named Shaynok? He may possibly hold the key to the discovery of the Lawgiver's fifth scroll.
Yeah.
What is this fifth scroll you mentioned?
Let me give you a bit of background. Caridian society is a rigid structure consisting of two distinct classes, the patricians and the plebeians.
Like Rome, then.
For the past 1,000 years, that structure has been governed by the laws derived from the four sacred scrolls. The first scroll outlines our code of honor. The second describes the relationship between the military and the government. The third defines the principles of our religion. And the fourth enumerates the privileges and responsibilities of the patrician class.
But you speak of another scroll.
According to legend, the lawgiver also wrote a fifth scroll defining the rights and privileges of the plebeian class, which were not explained in the other scrolls.
What makes you think Shaynok can help you?
My studies indicate that the followers ended up somewhere in what is now Federation space. But because our governments are not on friendly terms, I could never follow up on that research. But the Vulcan scholar Shaynok lives in the Federation and has made extensive studies of our history. I believe he may have vital information that will help us locate the followers.
Why are you so interested in this fifth scroll?
I am a scholar, Captain. My interest is purely academic. Lucana, on the other hand, is a social revolutionary. She hopes the scroll will inflame the underclasses to rebellion.
How would an ancient scroll do her any good?
The patrician stopped the lawgiver before he could reveal his fifth scroll. The lawgiver and a few of his disciples, known as the Followers, left Gerrit in 5 spaceships to start their own colony. No trace of them was ever found, and the story gradually took on mythic proportions.
Who is the lawgiver?
His real name was Avatrunai, and he was the architect of Caridian society. His 4 scrolls became the cornerstone of our entire culture. The fifth scroll could be the greatest social discovery in Gerrit's history. Even if you don't agree with Lucana's goals, I urge you to talk to Shaynok and help us find the scroll for science's sake.
This could be an intriguing quest.
Oh, Jesus. Federation will not take sides.
I have decided to visit Shaynok and see whether he can help you regarding the fifth...
Thank you for agreeing to visit Shaynok, Captain. The fifth scroll could be the greatest social discovery in Gerrit's history.
We have another... If you'll excuse me, I have other duties to attend to.
Right.
Captain Picard, my name is Lucana. On behalf of the oppressed underclasses of Gerrit, I'd like to thank you for rescuing us.
Don't thank me too quickly. You have illegally entered Federation space, and this ship is not a haven for criminals.
I am not a criminal, Captain. I am only seeking justice for my people.
Very well. You may stay on board the Enterprise until we have sorted this matter out.
Do not dismiss me so quickly, Captain.
Why do you say that?
I am searching for the fifth scroll.
Oh, God.
Who are the plebeians?
They are the underclasses of Gerrit.
Thousand years.
Why are you...
Finding the fifth scroll will free my people from tyranny because the scroll gives the rights to the plebeians, Garrett's lower classes. That's why the government doesn't dare let me...
If you'll excuse... Why is your own mother trying to kill you?
She is only doing her duty. I know she doesn't want to kill me, but she is under orders to prevent Lucana from finding the lawgiver's fifth scroll.
Why are you so
Because I believe in Lucana's crusade. Even though I was born a patrician, Lucana has made me aware of the plebeian suffering. The fifth scroll would give them a more honorable place in Caridian society.
I sympathize with your cause, but I must
And we are not asking you to do so, Captain. When the time comes, we will fight that battle ourselves.
Right, okay. God knows. Let's see what Riker's saying.
Any suggestions, number one?
A
I'm sorry, Captain, I don't have any suggestions right now.
Fuck you. Prick. Worf.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain, we should check our orders from Starfleet.
Good thinking, Worf.
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest...
Yeah, contact... How? Tactical... Comms? There we go.
Admiral Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
What's your assessment of our recent performance?
The Enterprise's presence in this region has set a lot of minds at ease, but I'm still concerned about the Romulan activity in the area. Look sharp, Captain.
I'd like to confirm our current orders.
Of course. Starfleet Command is still considering the options. While we review the situation, the Enterprise is to remain on patrol.
What is the current situation, Admiral? Is there anything in particular we should be aware of?
Actually, things are relatively quiet right now. The only cause for concern is all the Romulan activity in the area.
Picard out.
Right. I think we were supposed to be on patrol or something.
Any suggestions?
I'm sorry.
Riker. Can I speak to Deanna? Yeah.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain, but I don't have any suggestions right now.
I've got a suggestion. Right.
Mr. Data, any...
I suggest we contact Star...
Done that. Can I... Astrogation? Holodeck! Oh, right, okay. That's annoying. That's just how you look at the cutscenes, it seems. Right. That's patient.
Selected destination is a quasaroid. Warning. Selected destination is a quasaroid.
Apologies if that music was a bit loud. It was right in my ear, that was. I've got absolutely no friggin' idea. Am I supposed to remain on patrol?
Mr. Worf,
Captain.
Admiral Williams here. Of course, Starfleet.
Picard out.
Mentioned something about being on
the fifth group.
Understood. Mr. Worf, inform Starfleet that we will be
aye, sir.
Computer, what are the current whereabouts of the Vulcan archaeologist Shaynock?
According to Federation Archaeological Survey records, Shaynock is currently excavating ruins on the planet Horst 3.
Right. Set course for Horst 3, warp 5.
Aye, sir.
Engage.
There we go.
Receiving an emergency transmission from Simcoe 4.
Simcoe 4?
Yes, sir. The work at Merton's orbital station focuses on power generation. The researchers there are among the best in the Federation.
On screen. This is Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the Federation Starship Enterprise. How can we be of help?
Captain Picard, I am Deneb, Chancellor of Simcoe. We are in need of immediate assistance. Merton's orbital station has been attacked by an unknown vessel and does not answer our hails.
Attacked? But the station is a purely scientific facility.
Is the attacking vessel still present?
We do not know. Whoever or whatever they were, our sensors did not detect them.
Perhaps it was a cloaked Romulan vessel.
I doubt the Romulans would venture this far into Federation territory. The risks are too great.
Captain, you must hurry. The attack has destabilized the station's experimental power core. We don't know how long we have until a core breach, but I can...
What about survivors? Did anyone get off the station?
We detected several escape pods, but we haven't recovered them yet. The pods we detected could hold only a few dozen. There are hundreds aboard the station.
Set course for Simcoe 4.
Thank you, Captain.
We'll do our best. Dr. Crusher.
Crusher here.
Doctor, we may shortly be taking on a large number of wounded, possibly hundreds.
How much time have I got?
Not enough, I'm afraid. Picard out. Miss LaForce?
Yes, Captain.
We're en route to Merton's orbital station. They've been attacked, and they're going to...
I'll see what I can dig up, but the Simconians do some advanced work. It may take a while to figure it all out.
Then I suggest you work quickly. Millions of lives on the planet's surface may be at stake. I expect a full analysis of the situation and...
Yes, sir.
Engage.
Okay, so we're going to Simcoe 4 then. Warp 7, 31 light years away. But honestly, just going to like sit and wait. So my plan for this video is actually just to sort of play this for maybe about an hour. I can't really give sort of any like running commentary. I've got no idea what to do in this game.
Captain's log. We have arrived at the Simcoe system in response to a distress call regarding Merton's orbital station. The station was apparently attacked by unknown forces, leaving it in danger of a power core breach.
We're within sensor range of the Merton's orbital station, sir.
On screen. Miss LaForge?
LaForge here.
Report. What is the condition of the station?
You're looking at what's left of the Merton's Orbital Station, one of the largest research centers in the Federation. The focus of their work is on power generation. 5 years ago, they built the prototype of an experimental power core, and it's been running the station ever since.
Power generation studies? That doesn't warrant an assault like this.
I've been in contact with Starfleet headquarters. Power generation is only part of what this station studies. For several years, researchers here have been working on new ways to detect cloaked vessels.
If the Romulans discovered this, they might have risked a raid. The Simconians did not detect the attacking ship. It may have been cloaked.
That's speculation, Mr. Worf. We have no proof the Romulans were involved.
Well, whoever it was, something powerful punched through the station's shields and sliced off an entire research wing.
What do you mean, sliced off?
There is insufficient debris in the area to indicate that the missing section was destroyed. It is possible the attackers simply removed it.
Geordi, could that be what destabilized the power core?
No, and that's what I can't figure out. Damage to the upper deck should only cause minor problems, but I'm reading serious power fluctuations. Maybe serious enough to breach the power core's containment field.
What will happen if the containment field fails?
I can't say for certain, but with the amount of energy that thing can put out, I wouldn't want to be around it when it goes.
Is there any way to shut down the core?
There's a fail-safe mechanism which is supposed to jettison the core automatically in an emergency.
I'd say this qualifies as an emergency. Why wasn't the core jettisoned?
The only way to prevent it is by manual override. Someone has to be there to stop it.
That means there's someone still alive in there. Data, are you picking up any life signs?
The station's shielding is interfering with our sensors. I cannot tell if any of the crew are still alive. However, life support is still functioning. But power readings indicate that it may fail at any time.
Dr. Crusher.
Crusher here.
We are nearing Merton's station. Are you prepared for casualties?
My staff is ready to do double shifts. We can handle about 330 emergency cases, but we'll have to beam the rest down to Simcoe.
Understood. What is your recommendation?
We can't do anything from here, but to get an away team aboard, we have to find a way through those shields.
I believe I have a solution. The station's upper shields are badly damaged. If we establish a lock on a transporter on the upper decks, a transporter beam could penetrate the weakened shields.
Once we're in, we should be able to jettison the power core. Then we can lower the station's shields and evacuate the wounded.
Very well, Number One. Make it so.
Geordi, I want you and the rest of the away team ready to go in 20 minutes.
We'll be there in 10.
Okay. So I'm just gonna play this for a little bit, see how far I get. I'm gonna save here, actually. What's it called? Simcoe? I'll do. Save. Well, that was a long time ago. I've done this bit, and I don't think Starfleet was very happy with my solution to this. So I think let's go to transporter. Here we go.
Beam down coordinates selected. Beam down coordinates selected.
Who? So you can actually change. I did think that you could change your away team. Surely Data should go. Carlstrom and Butler, yeah. How do you? Select which one of their way team to control, and then move them around. So I don't know what this is. What is that?
It's a medkit.
Oh, thanks, Jordy. Tricorder.
Subsystems are down. Inertial dampers, life support, no telling how long until these power surges overload the backups. We'd better hurry. I don't see anything. Titanium-duranium alloy in a memory gel suspension. It's completely self-sealing.
You just made half of those words up.
You mean the station heals itself?
That's one way to put it. The attack caused major structural damage. If this were any other station in the Federation, we'd be standing in a vacuum.
So there appears to be a body over here. Walked a big cable. Trapped woman. Walked a trapped woman. Look at trapped woman.
That cable must be over 1,000 kilograms. We've got to get her out of there.
Right. Worf? Can you pick up that cable, Worf?
It is too heavy.
Yeah. Phaser on cable?
Cable has been cut through.
Okay.
We should conserve our phase.
Right. Wifey.
She cannot be treated unless we move the cable. It is too heavy.
You just cut it in half?
It is too heavy.
Right, okay, so it's a... Jordy, you need to do something.
I wouldn't try it. If that cable shifts, we could...
Can we not just beam her out? The hell's that? A medical tricorder. Offer! Right.
She's got multiple fractures in both legs. The bones in the lower part of her left leg are shattered. She's in shock and there's some... All things considered, she's very lucky. I can take care of the worst of her injuries. There's no need for... I can't do anything for her until we get that cable out of the way.
Right, well, I already cut it in half.
We should conserve.
work.
I could, move.
Big it is piece. Too heavy.
Off. Riker! It came up there saying, piece of metal, move.
We can't risk it. If the cable shifts, it could crush her.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Dr. Crusher is the...
Right, move over there, move out of the way. Right, Geordi, look.
We can't move this section, it's still too risky. But it might be small enough to transport.
Right, so do that. Use comm badge, comm badge. What the hell does that mean? Oh, shit! Settings for the phaser. Can we talk to Enterprise?
I don't think that's... We can't risk it if the... Unfortunately, we... Unfortunately...
It's still too.
So Geordi had the idea of transporting it. Again, apologies if that's a bit loud. Oh, but I was mucking around with the volume settings with this for ages. Right. Tricorder. Use tricorder on piece of cable.
It's a high capacity data transfer cable, probably a main communications line. This cable's built for handling information, not energy. I'm surprised it didn't just vaporize when it was hit. It didn't work. It didn't work. I wouldn't try it. Looks like that was their primary communications line. That cable must be over a... Looks like that was their... That cable must...
Am I missing something here? What's the gist? Must be some way to contact the Enterprise.
We do not have time to tend to the wounded. The power core is in a critical state.
There's no way to move that data cable ourselves. Maybe we could use the transporter. The readings we've taken are good enough for a transporter lock.
All right. So you're gonna do it. You're gonna do it.
We can't risk it if...
Stabilize, shall we? Maybe we can do that. Turbo lift. Let's go to engineering. The fuck?
I'd say we found our intruder.
The hell is that thing?
I'd say we found...
Geordi.
Amazing. It's using a plasma suspension beam to draw energy straight out of the main conduits. Of neutronium hull and internal energy, but now all I can pick up are natural elements. It's sending false readings to our tricorders. It's like a chameleon. It disguises itself perfectly. If we weren't here to see it, we'd never know it was here. It could probably fool our ship sensors just as easily. This chameleon field seems to take a fraction of a second to adjust to new scanning frequencies. There. I'm getting a...
Evidence of phaser capability. Subject is warp capable. Device origin unknown.
Yep, it's a neutronium hull, all right, and a powerful energy source. I've never seen that much power in such a small package before.
Right. Should. maybe not. Let's control, core control. Ah! Oh, you're joking. Oh, for fuck's sake.
Geordi is the Enterprise.
He's stunned.
Oh, thank God for that. Medkit?
There's no need.
No need? Right. Wrecker. Let's go this way then. Fortunately, now we don't have our engineer to help with the engineering. But what the hell's all this?
It's a graviton probe. It's a variable pulse negator. It's a wave reduction converter. Looks like a phase inverter. Looks like a plasma shunt.
Yeah, yeah. A plasma
Looks like
shunt.
A plasma shunt.
Yeah. Right. We must have time. But if Geordi were here, he would be able to tell us. Right. Okay. No. Okay. Nothing else here, it seems. Oh, there. What the hell? Geordi. Can you tell us a bit more about this?
I don't see
things?
Anything special about it. A graviton probe. That could be useful when you're dealing with a gravitic power source.
Yeah, he knows his stuff.
Pulse negators are used for canceling fluctuations in pulsed energy systems. A wave reduction converter. We might be able to use this. It's a specialized tool for dampening graviton flux waves. That's a phase inverter coupling. It's for reconnecting multi-phase energy channels and correcting flux modulation problems. I don't think we'll need this plasma shunt. The main power source here is definitely not plasma-based.
Okay, so maybe one of these will help with that wifey upstairs. But as for that machine, I don't know. There was administration I could go to. Somehow. Is there a way back up? You fuck. Oh my god. Right, so leaving the room and coming back, does that unstun him?
Geordi's been hurt.
Oh, what?
There's no need for that.
You just said he'd been hurt? Oh, there's the turbo lift. Look, Geordi's back. He's back up. He's fine. Crew deck 2? Oh, no. Administration. Panel. Geordi, you're the man of the hour. Well, he's
a lot of these systems are out. A lot of these systems... I think we're in luck. This life support console's still active.
Okay.
Life Life support will fail if we don't get it stabilized soon. Once it fails, we won't have much time.
Enter authorization code. So is that like... what the... so do I type something?
Life support will fail if...
oh, it's not working. Want authorization. Just lets me exit. Exit.
A lot of these systems are... it's dead. Power surge. It's dead. Power surge. It didn't. I don't see anything special about it.
It's a window.
I don't see anything special about it.
Holotable.
Looks like a power surge knocked out the holotable. I could fix it if we had more time. Or if I had a flux router, I could bypass the damage completely.
Flux router, okay. Are we getting somewhere? Are we? Flux router, engineering. One of these was a flux router, wasn't it? Graviton probe, pulse. No, none of these was a flux.
That's a phase inverter coupling. It's for reconnecting multi-phase energy channels and...
correcting flux. Might as well. Oh, there's a flux router. It's not the thing that you said. No, it's a plasma shunt. Right, okay. Right, let's get that.
We have to get past that machine out there.
We do not have sufficient...
what is it doing?
It appeared to be drawing plasma from the third conduit cluster.
Well, that's it. It's collecting energy. Maybe if we can temporarily shut off the power, it'll leave.
Make it think the wells run dry.
There should be emergency shutoff controls around here somewhere.
Right, well, I was going to try and do this thing with a fuck. Right, use flux router on table. Yeah! Yep.
Look at this damage report. Only a few very specific sections were hit. No random damage at all. This wasn't an attack. This was surgery.
I've still got no friggin' idea what to do about the bloody life support, though.
I think we're in luck.
Who would know? Morph? Would you know how to use this? Life support.
If we revive the injured woman, she may be able to tell us about the attack.
Okay, so we've got to do that. I've got to help the woman to get the code, to get the thing. Right, crew deck. It says phaser set to... Speak.
That will not work.
Right. Revive wifey. Use medkit on trapped wifey. I'm just gonna say no. I just know it.
I can't do anything for her until we get that cable out of...
I've been trying to. Bloody Bev.
If we move the cable, we may injure her.
So what the hell?
If we move the cable...
Riker, you... what's going on about?
Unfortunately, we... I don't think that... we can't risk...
transporting it. There must be some way... that's just got... as options. Blah blah blah. Resume. There must be some way of contacting Chief O'Brien. Getting him to beam up that piece of cable.
I've been thinking about how to free that trapped crewman. What if we use the station's transporter to remove the cable?
Station's transporter?
I've already got the coordinates we need.
Right, station's transporter. So where do I find that? Was that back in here? Thank you. complete.
All primary subsystems are down. Inertial dampers, life support, no telling how long until these power surges overload the backups. We'd better hurry.
Transport.
On this console, we can do point-to-point beaming inside the station's shields.
Right. On it. Oh, what the f... Data cable. Energize. Yeah, bruv. Not Riker at the door. No. Jesus, come on, Geordi. Geordi, come on. And those three just hanging about. They're gonna like beam. Watch them. Watch these three. Geordi's walking all that way, and they're just gonna beam where the wife is. There you go. Looks like that. Good work, Chief O'Brien. Right, now. Medkit on Wifey.
That takes care of the worst of her injuries. She's coming around now.
Right, get Worf to speak to her when she wakes up. Maybe not. Riker. You put the moves. He knows how to talk to women.
How do you feel?
Yeah, how do you feel?
I'll manage. You're from Starfleet, aren't you?
Yes, we're from the Enterprise. We just arrived.
Already he's thinking. Look at those eyes.
Thank goodness you're here. I'm Anna Bennett, Chief Medical Officer. Listen, we've got a lot of wounded here. How many can you evacuate?
We can get everyone, but not until we lower the shield.
We can't do that until we stabilize or jettison the power core.
There's a hostile alien device of some kind down below.
Oh, yeah.
Have you seen it?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what you're talking about. There shouldn't be anything down there but conduits and control panels.
I'd bet anything that's what caused the second impact and breached the hull. Sure got the weapons for it.
I'm not involved in the energy experiments they do down there in engineering. But I do know there are no weapons on this station except the ones you're carrying. If it's armed, it isn't ours.
We need some help.
What is it?
We need the access code to put life support on emergency power.
But that should happen automatically.
Only if the main power has been interrupted. The core is still providing power.
So the emergency system never kicked in. But if there's main power, why shift to emergency power?
The fluctuations in main power are getting worse. A big enough surge could overload the life support system.
I warned them about using an inherently unstable power source. I never thought it would come to this. The code is 334L42.
Thank you. We'll stabilize life support. Then we'll see about that power core.
You should jettison that thing. If it breaches the containment field, life support will be the least of our problems.
We'll be back to check on you later.
All right.
Right. Let's get that. Hopefully I don't have to. 334L42. Right. Hopefully. Getting somewhere. Progress. Good old Riker. He knows how to talk to trap women. Right. Oh, this is the wrong friggin' room. Sorry. Starfleet coming through. Administration. Right, here we go. Use life support. There we go. Right, is that... Okay. Power redirect use shutdown. Right, okay. Oh, the hell? Does that do anything? Redirecting power, shutting down. I redirect. Life support disconnected, operating emergency power only. Life support at minimum. levels. Okay. Is that it then? Is that that done?
Energy surges have fused these controls. With all the damage this station suffered, I'm surprised it's still holding together.
What? Geordi.
I'd sure like to get a look at that power core. Just one of these.
Right, so I don't know if maybe this inverter coupling.
I can't make it work with.
We do not have sufficient.
Phasers probably won't hurt that hovering machine, but turning off its power might. Let's try a temporary shutdown of all power to the third conduit group.
Oh, we have to find some way around that strange...
Temporary shutdown of... Don't think any of that stuff's gonna help.
Sensors detect the enemy?
We never knew what hit us.
Where's the...
Most of...
The powers...
It's this insane experiment Dr. Greems and some of the other researchers put in...
We've been reading some pretty severe power fluctuations. Is that normal?
How should I know? Those maniacs. You know what they've got down...
Now wait a minute. You said the power source was unstable. A singularity is dangerous, but it doesn't fluctuate like this.
Greems came up with some scheme to increase the energy output. Something about gravity waves. I don't know all the details, but it involved destabilizing the containment field.
We'll come back for you as soon as the station...
All right.
I mean...
The most likely place for the jettison controls is in engineering. Let's go.
Yeah, but there's that stupid
The power
thing.
Core controls are probably on the lower level.
I hope the controls we need aren't in one of the...
The life support. What's everyone saying now?
Most likely place for the jettison.
The power core could.
I hope the controls we.
Damaged conduit. Right, let's see if they have any ideas.
Oh, we have to find some.
Phasers probably won't hurt that hovering machine, but turning off its power might.
Temporary. So turning off the power.
We do not have.
But there was power controls in that other room, but they were fused. So I'll just try that again. Administration.
A lot of these systems are out. it's dead.
Lieutenant Worf, the ship's security chief.
Yeah. But is he dead or what? What's going on?
He's stunned.
Okay. So we can't get past the damn thing, so...
I'd say that alien machine cut through the conduit casing to get at the energy inside. I can't make it work.
Well, hold on. If I look at my tricorder... I wonder if...
A wave reduction converter. We might... A graviton probe. Pulse negators are used for...
I wonder if this pulse negator...
It didn't work.
What do you mean? Pulse negator.
I don't see anything.
That's a
wave reduction converter. I don't think we'll need this plasma shunt. The main power source...
It's definitely something to do with... A Worf's back. Hey, Worf. You're right. Pulse negator on
I chain. Can't make it work.
I've done this before. I can't bloody remember. I can't get to the core control room. Turbo lift. Insightful, interesting look at this game. See, this is the thing about I like adventure games. I like point and click games, but it's the getting stuck on puzzles that just does my freaking head in. As much as I enjoy playing them, enjoy the story and like the sort of the situations, it's.
I don't see anything special about it.
You know, like newer point-and-click games, if you can sort of call things like the Telltale games, point-and-click games, you know, they're really fairly quite easy and simple, the puzzles. But this, back in, you know, this kind of era, Monkey Island and all the Sierra game, point-and-click games, some of the solutions were really obscure. Oh my god. No! I don't fucking believe that.
Beam down coordinates selected.
So that's how you do it. That's how you do it. but it wasn't. See, I knew, but it wasn't the solution to the problem. Oh dear. Okay. No, I think, I think that's probably enough for today. I might come back to this, I might not. I was thinking about doing another Birth of the Federation video to sort of update, like a late game kind of update on that one, since there's a lot more going on in Birth of the Federation that I didn't actually show in that video. So I don't know, I mean, I might come to this. Hopefully, I'm a little bit concerned that the volume's going to be all to shit in this, because there's quite a lot of background noise. But anyway, we'll see. Anyway, I hope you all enjoyed this video and this look at Star Trek The Final Unity. Okay, I'm just going to save. Save as fit. There we go. Right, well, thanks very much for watching, everyone. I'll, Riker. Right. See you later, guys.